Good afternoon from the KOCO Weather Center. This is Chief Meteorologist Damon Lane for your April 24th, 2014 noon weather webcast here. Temperatures going to be fairly decent this afternoon across the southern plains, 60s and 70s across Kansas, mid to upper 70s across Oklahoma here. Again, temperatures feeling pretty nice. We're going to see that heat still all the way down in the South Texas here as you go down into the Rio Grande Valley. Temperatures climbing up near 100 degrees. We're going to start to see that warmth return as we go in the Friday afternoon. We're highs across Oklahoma, able to reach the low to mid 80s from OKC out near Clinton and even mid to upper 80s in southwestern Oklahoma. Eastern Oklahoma, temperatures in the upper 70s near 80 degrees. Still a fairly pleasant spring afternoon across the Sooner State, but as we go into Saturday afternoon, more warmth and even more instability coming in here. High temperatures climbing into the upper 80s across Oklahoma City, even a few areas climbing into the 90s, and we're going to see those 90s extend all the way up into Kansas and then all the way down into Texas here. So it certainly looks like it is going to be a fairly warm, if not even hot, afternoon as we go into Saturday. And of course, a threat for severe weather will be increasing as the heat rises and so does the instability. We're watching the system right here that as we go into Saturday afternoon, we'll be moving across the Four Corners region of the United States. It will keep moving up to the northeast, and because of that, we do have a slight risk for severe weather. This is the official risk for severe weather, and that slight risk for severe weather extends from Nebraska through Kansas, across much of Oklahoma, and down into Texas, with the potential that this could get upgraded officially by the Storm Prediction Center to a moderate risk for severe weather. This is looking at two weather models and the amount of instability that we're going to have in place. No matter which model you're looking at here, whether you're looking at the GFS model or the NAM model, both are going to show that we're going to see at least instability readings in the 2 to 3,000 joules per kilogram category here. Now, of course, that might sound like a lot of weather speak right there, but basically, if you look at the bar on the left-hand side here, we're going to be looking at instability that's going to be in this red shading area, and the higher you go, the more instability you have. So certainly, we're going to be in the fairly high range in a very unstable atmosphere, mainly west of I-35 if you go off of the GFS model, or even basically, you know, west of I-35 if you're going off of the NAM model. No matter which model it is, both have a lot of instability in place. So as we look at the Euro model on storm development as we go in the Saturday afternoon, storms are likely to have the potential to develop across the big country of Texas and to western Oklahoma and across Kansas, with the chance that these could have some tremendous amount of significant severe weather impacts. With them, we're talking about hail, winds, and a tornado risk. As we go into about Sunday morning, about 1 a.m., we still have storms still out there, mainly southwest of OKC, but certainly moving in toward the metro. And then as we go into Sunday morning at about 7 a.m., when the OKC marathon is ongoing, rain and storms are still likely going to be out there. So it could be a messy run for those of us who are going to be taking part in the OKC marathon. And not only that, but some of these storms still could be producing quite a bit of severe weather, at least with them, with heavy rainfall and hail. I expect that the tornado risk should be decreasing as we go way into the Sunday morning time frame here. And then as we go into Sunday afternoon, that threat for severe weather will move east of I-35 here for all these areas shaded in red. This is a day four outlook, so we're going to call this a slight risk right here. And as we look at the Euro model, we can see storms are moving in the eastern and southeastern Oklahoma. No doubt about it, a very busy next couple days when it comes to severe weather chances, and we'll have an update on what you can expect as we head into the weekend coming up tonight on KOCO 5 News at 5, 6, and 10. See you then.